What's going on, my friends? This is Dustin with Electrician U, and today we're going to talk wire nuts. Why is it important to know the difference between all of these different wire nuts? Why are there so many wire nuts? Really, it's just a size factor for the most part. For most general use wire nuts, like this back row here, it's just size, number of conductors that you can fit in a wire nut, and what size wire. Sometimes you get really big wires, so you need something huge like this. Sometimes you get itty bitty wires, and you need something really tiny like that. Most of the time in the middle, we're gonna use reds, or we're gonna use these whites or yellows. I mean, it just kind of depends on the situation. If you need a little bit more room inside of a box and you're trying to push wires and you've got really big like lighting control system, you know, dimmers, Lutron radio raw dimmers or anything like that, and you're like pushing to smash everything in. Well, if you change all your wire nuts from reds down to yellows, if the wire permits, it actually saves you a lot of room. So there's reasons size-wise why we would use all these different wire nuts. And then this front row is more like specialty wire nuts. They have a very specific purpose to them. So you'll actually go out looking for that specific thing. So, like these crimp sleeves, not really a wire nut. It's more of a crimp sleeve that's got insulation on it. I'll get into that in a minute. But you've got things that you use specifically for ground, specifically for copper and aluminum, for high temperature, multi-use. So it combines several different functions of other wire nuts into one wire nut. Or, you know, direct burial, waterproof, something that you're going to put outside. So let's start breaking into them. We'll talk about each one and why you should care about that one. So first, let's start out with the itty bitty grays. These grays are used, the minimum size is 3 number 22s, or the max size is 2 number 16s. Really, if you're doing anything low voltage with like, 16, 20 gauge wire, a lot of that's going to be Cat 5, or it's going to be like maybe security wire, probably not speaker wire. Really anything that's like network cable, really small stuff that you have to strip out and put wire nuts on, you're gonna use these tiny little ones. Same thing with the blues. The blues are just a step up. So this is 3 number 20s to 3 number 16s. So it's a little bit more forgiving. This you could probably use for some really small speaker wire, a little bit larger, or if you're putting more network cables together under one wire nut, if you're doing work in ballasts, a lot of times ballasts have like 16 or 18 gauge wire. So you can use these up in ballasts and it kind of just keeps everything out of the way. Although I like using Wagos instead. We'll get into that in a different video. Next up on our list are the oranges. Oranges are kind of a mid-sized wire nut, so you can fit 1 number 18 in here all the way up to 2 14s. So this starts getting into interior residential wiring if you're ever doing stuff with 14 gauge wire, which most of the time people aren't using 14 gauge wire these days. It just depends. Some municipalities don't like it, some don't care, some you can do all your LED lighting in it because it's such, low current lighting. But like all of your regular circuitry, they would do a number 12. But these oranges are handy because a lot of like fixture wires and things like that are really small, so you can get away with packing a whole bunch of these into a box, and it just saves you space. Next up on our list is the yellows. So yellows are, I have probably just as many yellows, whites, and reds in my pouches at all times as the others. I don't have really one more or the other. I use these yellows when I can fit something into a tight space and I'm trying to save space. Whereas I'll use probably the reds if I don't really care. The reds are kind of my default, but the yellows will save a lot of space, especially if you're doing like four gangs, or if you have, say you have a four gang and you've got like two different circuits coming in, plus you have travelers and you've got two different three ways going on, and the hot side of one three way and the leg side of another, or some crazy thing where you're gonna have a whole bunch of wire nuts in there, I would use these yellows just because it saves space. You can fit 3 number 12s in it, so that's a really nice thing to have. If you're doing more than that, if you need more than 3 12s, or if you want to start using number 10s, these whites are a really good place to start. You can't fit a lot. I think you can fit 3 number 10s max. The smallest that will bite in here is 2 number 20s, so that's still like two really small wires, so that's a good range. This is kind of an all-around really badass wire nut for everything. 3 number 10s is gonna fill this thing up, but like, most of the time when you're working with with any number 10s, you know, you're probably going to be doing two of them. So that's really great. I would still personally probably use the reds for number 10s. That's just because they fit in there easier. You got them on you all the time anyways, and you don't have to really worry about if anything's going to be coming out of the backside of it or not. This covers it really well. So that brings me to the reds. The reds are probably the most commonly used wire nuts that you're going to see out there. They will fit at minimum two number 18s that'll actually bite on in there. If you put like one 18 or like two number 20s and you try to stick them in there, it's just gonna keep spinning. It won't bite. So it'll actually bite on two 18s. And then the max that you can fit is four number 12s. That's why people use these for residential, because we're using number 12 wire the vast majority of the time. And to fit four of them in one wire nut is super helpful. So these are my go-to for most things, or they have been for the longest time. Next up on our list are the blues, the big blues. So big blues are for really large wire or for a lot of wires. Now, they're not necessarily listed to put like eight number 12s in here, but they're really handy if you're doing stuff with like number six, number eight wire. They're listed for, bizarrely enough, they're not listed for like three number eights. They're listed for one number six and two number eights put together. That's the max size. Nobody's gonna do that. Nobody's gonna have two number eights and one number six that they're gonna stick in a wire nut. So like, I get it. You're trying to fit the marketing to make it seem like you can put a lot more in the wire nut, but realistically, three number eights is what this should be listed for as a max, because that's what circuitry we're going to be coming across, and that's what we're gonna use these for. So three number 12s, you can actually use this for three 12s if you had to as well. I probably wouldn't do that because they take up a lot of space. You start sticking three of these in a box and holy crap, you know, you're running out of space very, very quickly. But these things are a lifesaver, especially four gang boxes where you got a whole bunch of neutrals. Sticking one of these in there will definitely do the trick. So that's it for our general purpose wire nuts, the regular use. So let's start talking about some more of the specialty items. These are crimp sleeves, so these are actually insulated crimp sleeves. They're not even wire nuts. They're not like twist-on wire nuts. There's actually just a little crimp inside of here that you would crimp, but it has an insulated shield around it. So these look like wire nuts, and you're gonna see them on a lot of ballasts and a lot of light fixtures that are pre-manufactured. They crimp their connections in the factory. But I just figured I'd put them in here because it kind of looks like a wire nut, so people might think it's a wire nut. Anyways, it's for number 22 to number 10 conductors. Next up on our list are the greenies, or the ground wire nuts, green ground wire nuts. These are specifically designed. They're pretty much like a red as far as what they can hold inside of them. Same spring, same build. So you're looking at two 18s all the way up to, I think, four 12s, yeah. But the unique thing is that there's a hole right in the center of them. And what that's for is, say you've got like three grounds, but you only need one ground coming out. You'd have to bunch all three of those wires, twist them together, split two of them off, and cut them off so that you've only got one coming out. But you don't want to just leave those wires like that and fold them in the back of the box, because that can start coming loose. So you still want to put a wire nut over all of them to keep them tightly together, but you want one of them to come to be able to come out at the end of it. So it's kind of a very specialized thing that you're only going to use for grounds. Next up, we're going to talk about the copper to aluminum, or Kolar, wire nuts. These are purple. Notice purple, everything in purple has to do with bringing aluminum and copper together. There's a special pookie that they make, Nolux, that you're supposed to put. There's a special kind of compound in here that's an antioxidizing compound. So if you put copper and aluminum wires together so that they have a less chance of degrading each other over time or rusting each other, you would stick this on those wires, and there's all that stuff inside of it, pookie inside of it. So that's what these are listed for. Now, these are very expensive. You notice I only have two of them here. These two probably cost like $7. So you get a big pack of them, you're gonna spend a whole lot of money. But a lot of times people will go out in homes that are built in like the 50s, you know, and they've got a whole bunch of aluminum wire, and they're putting all brand new devices, but they don't, you know, they're instead of using Kolar devices and trying to use the aluminum and hooking up to receptacles, they want to pigtail aluminum and copper conductors together, bring the copper to the device so that the device and the copper wire are like fresh or whatever. Instead of using Kolar devices, I get it. I get like why people don't want to do that. Everybody's scared of aluminum. But that's when you're going to run into these, and it's really expensive. Next up on our list are the high temp wire nuts. So most of these wire nuts, if not all of them, I don't know if all of them, but the majority of these wire nuts are all rated at 221 degrees Fahrenheit, meaning that's what they can handle before this plastic starts melting. So high temp wire nuts are usually used for up in like metal halide fixtures or environments where there's a whole lot of heat. They need to be able to handle that high temperature without melting, because once it melts, you've just got metal inside here and two wire nuts laying up against each other. Once they melt, boom, those conductors touch each other and blow up. So you need something high temp. So these are 302 degrees Fahrenheit. So not quite 100 degrees hotter, but like that's a definite huge improvement. That's like taking, an entire like from 0 to 80 degree difference in temperature and adding that on top of the standard wire nuts. So you always want to use these when you're doing stuff with HID, like metal halide, high pressure sodium, mercury vapor, stuff like that. Next on the list are the waterproof direct burial wire nuts. So these are characteristic blue pretty much all the time. They come in all different sizes, just like these do, but what's special about them is on the inside, they've got a silicone compound in there that's like just this goopy, greasy stuff that they fill with them. So what it does is just keep water out. It repels water, essentially. It's not water soluble. So you would use these if you're in a direct burial environment, if you're doing something with UF. Now, if you're doing work outside and it's like 120 volts that you're running underground, I personally would not use these. I'm gonna do something that's like an actual splice kit, an underground direct burial splice kit, where it's bolting the wires together and making sure that they are not coming apart. Having twisted joints, I don't know, that's just my personal opinion. These are rated for it. They're actually listed for it. So if you had like UF that you were running underground, you could use these and bury them underground. I feel like that's kind of hacky. I think that there's a better way to do it, and I think direct burial splice kits are the way to go. All right, the last wire nut that I'm gonna talk about is a dual rated wire nut. So this is the Twister ProFlex from Ideal. It's kind of a new product for them, but if you go to like Home Depot, Lowe's, anything like that, you're gonna see these everywhere. What's cool about them and why they're my favorites is that it mixes two different wire nuts. There's a reason it's two colors, yellow and red. That's like mixing this yellow and this red together in one wire nut to give you a wider range for the same size, essentially. And inside of it, the actual coil is wider in this one, so you can fit 10s in this. It's rated for 4 10s, whereas this is only rated for 4 12s. So you need to be going by UL listings and what these things can handle when you're using them out in the field. But I just find that this can go to smaller sizes and bite smaller sizes and larger sizes than one of these. And I like it's rubbery. I don't know. It's kind of like maybe a gimmicky thing, but the feel of a wire nut in your hand actually matters. I don't know. There's certain, like, the more you do this, the more you'll have your go-to wire nuts that you like because of the way that they feel. And you would think that like rubbery and that extra size and everything would make them a lot more expensive than just a standard red, but they're not. They're like a few cents more per wire nut, depending on like what, you know, if you buy a 250 bag or 100 bag or like a 10 or 25 or something like that. But on average, they're really pretty close in cost. So there's not a huge cost differential. Like, I will go to a bag of these all day, every day. Again, because it's the same size and it gives you more. One cool thing you're probably gonna see, like orange blues. That's another dual rating that they've got. It's like mixing oranges and blues, putting them together into one wire nut so that they can get a wider range and for relatively the same size wire nut. A lot of those are also gonna have a skirting on them to kind of help fit all of those things in there. But anyways, that's pretty much it. That's the majority of wire nuts that you need to care about. I'm gonna do another video coming up where I do all different types of wire terminations, where it's like briefcases or suitcases, whatever you call them, crimp sleeves, wire nuts, like all kinds of different terminations. So I'll probably include some of these in there, but there's gonna be a much more diverse selection of things that you take wires and put them together with. So thank you guys so much for your attention. I hope you gained something out of this. Love you crazy people, and I will see you in the next one. We'll be right back.